have a new invention that I came up with after almost 20 years of research. I derived it mathematically. There are formulas for this. Later on in the video, you're going to see how the ancient Egyptians most likely electromagnetic field, believe it or not. Later on in the video, I'm going to show how this applies to physics, and it may produce a breakthrough of a grand theory of everything for the mathematician who can calculate the insane amount of formulas required to understand the dynamics going on here. This could possibly be the holy grail of mechanical engineering, the long sought after infinitely variable continuously variable transmission. And again, what you're seeing is a physics simulation. I used Blender, which I've been a developer on for a long time, because a lot of people say, well, that's a gaming engine, you know, how can you trust physics on that? Well, I've built prototypes in that work. So what's coming up here is how to build it without any tools. Okay, this is how the most likely the ancient Egyptians would have done it. These cactuses come out in natural forms. This shape actually arises a lot in nature. It comes out wherever is a pressing need. In other words, these cactuses have the largest surface area for any given volume, which is required for a cactus to survive, because it needs that surface area to gather the water. So when you have pressing circumstances where like the only way they exist is to use what you have to the ultimate. So here we have another kind of microbial life form also having that shape because of pressing circumstances. You know, these things barely survive. Okay, and now I'm going to go on to some ancient symbology. This here, which is a tetrahedron used as in Jewish religion, most likely the Jewish people were the ones who built the pyramids, so this would also tie into the whole thing. And here is a slightly more sophisticated imagining of it. Okay, this may produce better results. I have not tried it. And here is the seed of life. The seed of life basically is actually a schematic for this device, as I've discovered. It's how to space it, because the spacing is very important. And here's another ancient symbology. And this ancient symbology also has something to do with calculating the spacing. Now, I could go into that, but that's for I'll make that in another video. And so here's more symbology, how to calculate the spacings. So this, in my opinion, existed on Earth. This technology existed on Earth. I am rediscovering it, and basically have been able to try come up with explanations for all these ancient symbols and what they really mean. And the really big kicker is this here, which is called the trilobe disc. I just recently discovered this, and for the longest time I've been working on trying to figure out how to hold this device. Now, okay, how to hold this weird form, because this form has to actually be able to move around in a particular way. This is the perfect thing to hold it, and I've discovered that this is called the mysterious trilobe disc found in ancient Egypt and having something to do with wheels, and nobody knows what it's for. And so since it's a fractal gearing system, you should be able to fractally form it in multiples. Here is a schematic of how you might do that. Not exactly all the way sure about all the different configurations. That's why I'm putting this out here, because I want all the inventors in the world to really work on this and figure out what they can do with it, because really the full scope of this invention is beyond my life and beyond my ability. So I've done the beginning, and that's it. Now, I did say I was going to tell you how this ties into the physics and the grand theory of everything. In my opinion, this is how fields interact, and this is explains quantum entanglement. It explains unexplained laws of entropy. Here is a E8 geometry, E8 light group geometry representation. Garrett Lisi, a well-known physicist, has done a lot of work with that, and this is something he has called extremely simple grand theory of everything. Okay, in my opinion, the E8 light group is actually formed from the dynamics of this concept. Okay, and as you can see here, you know, the shadow of this three-dimensional object is always the same. So it explains some multidimensional ideas, like how multiple dimensions interact with each other, and how they, you know, it's really quite complicated. So I'm not gonna get into it, but I'm just gonna give a little touch. I'm just gonna touch it, and people can research it. And the next thing I'm gonna show you is how quantum entanglement can be explained. Now this should be a moving video. It should be animation, but it's not animating. So, well, as you can see, they actually spin around, and I'll try to put it in another different video. But these are some artist representations of what they call fractal gears. Okay, and this is how my infinitely variable continuously variable transmission system can explain quantum entanglement based on the fact that it's the dynamics of fields.